Fourth item naman tayo. Now, this item is medyo mahirap compared sa previous problems natin. But we can just streamline the process by ano tawag dito? Subdividing the problem. For a while ah. Yan. So for the beam shown daw, determine the slope at point C, the deflection at the free end, and the location and value of the maximum deflection midway between AC. Ito, yung simply supported span. So, again, medyo mahirap talaga to. So, we'll do this step by step na lang. Yan. So, for a while lang. Ito pala. Sige. So, first natin gagawin, let's try to solve the reactions. Now, meron tayong reaction sa A saka sa C. So, we have AY. AX is still 0 kasi walang horizontal load. Yan. We also have CY. So, sulat muna natin yung mga resultant ng loads natin. So, we have 10 multiplied by 3. So, 30. And then, this distance naman is 1.5 meters. Yan. And then, dito naman, we have our resultant. So, 1 half multiplied by 3 meters yung base, yung buo, multiplied by a height of 40. Yan. So, this is 1.5 multiplied by 40. This is 60. While itong distance na to is 1/3 of 3. Bakit 3? 3 kasi yung buong base ng triangle. Yan. So, we can now take moments about sa ano na lang. Sa A na lang ako mag-moment para mas madali yung moment arms. Kasi pag nasa sa C ako mag-moment, mas mahirap kasi naputol kasi yung triangular load. Yan. So, una ko na lang kunin is CY. So, summation of moments about A. We have ito, 30 times 1.5. And then, plus 60 multiplied by 1/3 of 3, which is 1, plus 1.5. I mean, 3 meters. Sorry. Then, minus CY, ito, multiplied by 5. So, set to 0, solve natin yung CY. Yan. So, CY pala is 57. Yan. And then, how about AY? To solve AY, we can just sum up forces vertical. So, minus 30 minus 60 plus AY plus CY, which is 57, equals 0. So, ano yan? Move natin lahat ng constant terms sa right side. So, 60 plus 30 minus 57. So, 33 pala yung AY. So, lagay din natin. Yan. So, move natin to. And then, kailangan talaga natin ng space para dito. So, move natin onto yung beam. Ayan. So, now, we have to make all the loads continuous up to the, ang tawag dito? Up to the point just right before the last segment. So, ito pala. Diyan yung cut natin. So, all loads must be continuous up to here. So, paano yan? Paano yan gagawin? Let's first try to check kung ano yung loads na hindi continuous. First, itong uniform load na 10 kN per meter, hindi siya continuous up to this point kasi naputol siya at point B. Diba? Now, itong triangular load din, yung height niya is nasa point B. Wala sa wala toward the cut natin. So, ibig sabihin, this is not continuous pala. So, dapat, we have to add ang tawag dito, dapat magdagdag tayo ng load to make this continuous. But then, we have to counteract that load na dapat continuous pa din siya sa cut natin. So, para streamline talaga, let's first make the 10 kN per meter load continuous. And then, remove na lang natin yung resultants pala. Wait lang. Yan. Again, 40 kN per m. So, itong load muna. Yung uniform load, gawin natin continuous up to the point. Itong cut natin. So, ito na lang, orange. Yan. So, continuous na yung ano natin, uniform load. Now, to make this more understandable, pwede mong palipare natin yung triangular load. Pwede yan siya. Kasi baka it might be confusing kasi nag-overlap na kasi yung load natin. So, pwede natin gawin. Move natin yan sa itaas. Yan. So, ito na yung triangular load natin. Yan. So, now, continuous na yung uniform load. So, dapat natin itong i-counteract. Itong in-add natin. Yan. So, counteract natin. We have a uniform load for which the magnitude is, this is 10, so this is also 10 din. Yan. Now, I also have to make the triangular load continuous. So, to make that continuous, I have to add this load. So, gamitan natin ng ito na lang, blue. So, add tayo ng ano na lang, green. Yan. Extend natin siya up to the cut. So, extend ko lang din yan. Yan. So, this is now a uniform load extending up to the cut. Now, since nag-add tayo ng triangular load, di ba? Ito yung in-add natin. So, we have to counteract it. So we can counteract it by adding a triangular load. So we have this one. Yan. And then yung height nito ng triangular load is 40 kilonewton per meter. Yan. So medyo marami yung equations natin. So now let's form the moment equation. So this is EI y prime prime. And then ito pala yung origin ng x natin patungo sa cut x. So we have 33 multiplied by x. Again, dito tayo mag-movement. Diyan. So 33x. Then we can now consider the uniform load. So for this uniform load, we have minus 10 multiplied by x. Ito yung resultant, and then moment arm is x divided by 2. Just review the discussions natin kahapon for the moment arms. Then next, we have ano ba yung maganda? Tapos na to. So we can consider ito naman, yung uniform load sa top. So the height is 40. Now it will cause a counterclockwise rotation pa rin. So minus 40. Now ano yung base niya? Yung base nito. Diba, this is x. Bawasan natin ng 3 meters. So x minus 3. So we have to use pointed brackets pala. Yan. Gawin na lang natin squared divided by 2. Kasi diba, ito naman siya for distributed loads. The moment arm squared divided by 2 kasi nasa gitna lang siya mag-act. So ito naman, gawin na lang din natin 10x squared divided by 2. Yan. Para ma-simplify talaga natin. So, tapos na tayo dito. Ito rin, tapos na. Para sa buong load. Then, ito naman is for this one. Yung load sa top. So, yung kulang na lang natin would be this one. And also, this one. Also, the reaction at C din pala. So, next. Plus tayo. Kasi yung rotation na makukause ng upward loads na nandito is clockwise. So kaya plus yung gagamitin natin. So meron tayong 10. Ito muna, yung uniform load. So 10 multiplied by a base of x minus 3. Pwede natin siyang i-square tas i-divide by 2. Yan na yung moment niya. Divided by 2. Yan. Then we have plus 1 half multiplied by a base of x minus 3. Yan. For this triangle na tayo. Ito. Now, the height of the triangle is 40. The base is 3. Again, we can use this one. So y in terms of x, diba ito 1 half multiplied by the base, multiplied by the height, yan na yung resultant. So, multiplied pala by, parenthesis lang muna kasi h over b to the n, constant naman yan. 40 is the height, the base is 3. Again, 40 tas 3. Then multiplied by x minus 3. Yan. And then moment arm is x minus 3 divided by 3. Again, galing yan sa triangle natin. Papakita ko. Ito. 1 half xy multiplied by x divided by 3. And then yung kanina naman, for the uniform load, dito yan galing. Ito. Wx multiplied by x over 2. Or wx squared divided by 2. Yan. Simplify na lang natin. Then finally, we have the reaction at C. It will cause a clockwise rotation kasi it is upward. So, plus 57 multiplied by x. Ano yung distance na yan? From here up to the cut. Diba, this is x, yung buong distance, minus natin yung 5 meters. Ito. So, x minus 5 pala. Now again, strictly for checking, just input the value of the whole span. Pag nag-zero yung singular moment equation mo, tama na siya. So, simplify lang muna natin to. Ayan. Tatlong x minus 3. So, i-join na lang natin. Then, yung denominator will become 2 times 3, 6, multiplied by 3, 18. So, then copy natin yung 40 multiplied by x minus 3 then cube natin. Tama ba? 40 18 tama. Then ito. So let's input the equation, then substitute natin yung x equals 6 for the whole span. So 33x minus 10x squared divided by 2 minus 40 times x minus 3 squared then divided by 2 plus +10 x minus 3 squared divided by 2 then plus 40 x minus 3 cubed natin divided by 18. Finally, we have plus 57 times x minus 5. So, press calc. Ito. Then, input natin at x equals 3 plus 2 plus 1, 6. So, diba, naging 0 siya. So, ibig sabihin, tama na yung moment equation natin. So, we can now proceed sa slope equation saka moment equation. So, for the slope equation, fast track ko na lang. We have EI y prime. So, ito, magiging 33 x squared divided by 2 then minus 10 x cubed divided by 2 times 3 then minus 40 times x minus 3 cubed divided by 2 multiplied by 3 then plus 10 x minus 3 cubed divided by 2 times 3 plus 40 times x minus 3 to the 4th divided by 18 multiplied by 4. Thus, plus 57 times x minus 5 squared na yan, then divided by 2. Then we have the arbitrary constant, which is C1. Yan. Now, for the deflection equation naman, we now have EIY. So this is 33 x cubed divided by 3 minus 10x to the 4th divided by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 4, then minus 40 x minus 3 to the 4th divided by 2 times 3 times 4 plus 10 x minus 3 to the 4th divided by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 4 plus 40 x minus 3 to the 5, 18 times 4 times 5. Then plus 57 x minus 5 cubed na yan, then divided by 2 multiplied by 3. Thus plus C1x plus C2. Now our first boundary condition is andito sa hinge support. So this is at x equals 0, walang deflection na mangyayari dyan. So y equals 0 then. Therefore, with these boundary conditions, C2 pala equals 0. But magkaka-value si C1. Kasi hindi siya fixed support sa left end. Now, the second boundary condition is andito sa roller support. So, at x equals 3 plus 2, 5. At x equals 5, wala rin deflection na mangyayari. So, y equals 0 pala. So, using the deflection equation, ito, masosolve natin yung C1. Now, apply natin yung the same kanina. Ito. C1 is the negative of the constant term pag in-apply mo yung boundary conditions divided by x. So, copy natin. Yan. Now, let's first simplify the equation. Yung values lang sa denominator. So, 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 4 is 24. So, 24. Ito rin. Ito. And then, 18 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 5 is 360. While this is 6. Yan. So, ibutin muna natin yung buong equation na to. But take note na yung boundary condition natin is at x equals 5. Y equals 0. Yan. So, lahat ng distances, papalitan natin ng 5. Now, ito, pwede natin i-exclude. Kasi, if x equals 5, then this will be 0. So, ito na lang. Input na lang natin to. So, we have 33 x cubed divided by 3 minus 10x to the 4th divided by 24 minus 40 times x minus 3 to the 4th divided by 24 then plus 10 x minus 3 to the 4th then divided by 24 plus 40 x minus 3 to the 5th hindi na siya kasha so press calc na lang and then input natin si 5 ito only up to this this one so we have to add this after so shift store lagay ko sa A so recall A then plus ko yan plus 40 again x becomes 5 5 minus 3 to the 5th divided by 360 yan so shift store lagay ko sa B so C1 pala equals negative of this value 395 33 divided by 36 divided by x which is still 5 so recall b negative pala recall b then divided by 5 so 219.63 ito pala yung C1 natin wait lang medyo may mali kasi yung C1 ko is check out check natin dito span is 6 this is at 5 tama then we have a uniform load 10 kN per m starting from A up to B so 3 meters lang then meron tayong triangular load from 3 meters up to the last point so this is starting from 40 ending at 0 yan so ito yung reactions natin 57 saka 33 so gawin ko yung 10,000 so dapat yung slope natin sa A must be 82.12778 and so iba siya dito so we have to double check gagawin ko na lang is dito na lang sa MathCAD dito ko na lang i-input di kasi siya kasya sa calculator so 33 over 3 2. Ah, okay. Ito pala. 2 multiplied by 3 dapat. divided by 2, then yes, hindi ko na include yung 2 multiplied by 3. Sorry. So this must be 6. Yan. Anyway, dito ko na lang input. So our deflection equation is this one. So 33 over 6 x cubed minus 10x to the 4th divided by 24 minus 40 x minus 3 to the 4th divided by 24 plus 10 x minus 3 to the 4th still divided by 24 then plus 40 times x minus 3 yan to the 5 over 360. Yan. And then, excluded pa yan, yung 57, kasi pag nag-input tayo ng 5, di yan kasali. So, plus tayo ng C1 multiplied by X. So, if X is 5, eto, yung equation natin, then the deflection is 0. So, equal 0, solve natin yung C1. So, ito pala, minus 14783 divided by 180. So, input lang natin. So, press equals, ito na, minus 82.128. This one. Yan. So, C1 is minus 14783 divided by 180, which is approximately minus 82.128. Yan. So, itong value ng C1, yan yung slope sa point A. And then, next naman, susolve natin yung nasa questions natin. So, first, we have to solve the slope at point C. Now, point C is at x equals 5. So, ano doon yung slope dyan? Now, gagawin ko, I will just input the slope equation dito na lang din sa MathCAD para mas madali. So, we have 33 x squared divided by 2 and then minus eto 10x cubed divided by 6 minus 40 multiplied by x minus 3 cubed divided by 6 then plus 10 multiplied by x minus 3 wala. Cube divided by 6. Then plus 40 x minus 3 to the 4th divided by 18 multiplied by 4 plus 57 pwede mo yung hindi na isali yung x minus 5 kasi at x equals 5 magiging 0 lang din yan but isasali ko na lang in case na magagamit siya sa future questions So x minus 5 squared divided by 6. I mean, slope equation 2 plus C1. Now yung C1, isusort ko na lang dito. C1. Yan. So now, I need the value of this para makuha ko yung slope at point C. So, Q, control G, then C. Yan. So, yung slope at C pala is nasa x equals 5 lang din. Ito. So, pwede natin siyang hindi na i-change. So, press equals 90.928 pala. Ito yung slope at C. So, copy ko na lang. Slope at C. Yan. This is at x equals 5. Now again, you can just eliminate this one. And then C1 natin is this value. So check down natin, positive 90.928. So ano yung direction niya? Slope at C pala is directed counterclockwise. 90.928. This is KN M squared. Bakit M squared? Kasi slope kasi yung hinahanap natin. Then divided by EI. Yan. So if it check natin, slope at C is at the roller support, which is at 5 meters. So at 5 meters, yan, the slope is 90.927. So this is correct. Now how about for the deflection at the free end? Now at the free end, this is at a distance of x equals 6. Yan, ito yung free end at D. So kukunin natin yung deflection equation, substitute natin yung 6. So balik tayo dito, sa MathCAD pala. Ito yung deflection equation natin. Yan. Copy natin. And then don't forget na meron palang plus 57 times x minus 5. Yan, kasali na yan siya kasi if x equals 6, this will now be positive. So 57 multiplied by x minus 5 cubed, then divided by 6 plus C1 multiplied by x. Now here x is 6. So press equals, this is now the deflection, delta control G deflection at C. Yan, 90.483. So, copy ko na lang. Wait lang. Ito pala. Yan, ito yung deflection at C. Which is at x equals 6. Yan. So we have 90.483 KN M cubed divided by EI. So pag i-check natin yan, deflection yung gusto natin, so this must be 10 million. Yan. So at point C, dyan na tayo sa right end. So ito, 90.483. So tama lang to. Yan. Now, itong next question, ito yung medyo mahirap. Kasi ano daw yung location and value of the maximum deflection midway between AC? So we have to check first. Diba, merong change in loading from A to B, we only have a uniform load. But andyan sa BC, may ibang loadings na. So dapat i-divide natin yung assumptions natin into two. First, we have to assume that the maximum deflection occurs within AB. The next, we have to assume na nasa BC siya. Now, yung AB, segment AB, if that's our assumption, it starts from x equals 0, then x, and then it ends at 3 meters. So, ito yung limits natin. Yan. And then, if our assumption naman is the maximum deflection ay nasa BC, we have to start from 3 meters up to what? This point. So, 5 meters. So, ano na lang? 0 to 3. Yan na lang. Then, from 3 to 5. If segment BC. So, if ito yung limits natin, dapat natin yung i-check. So, anyway, yung results lang yung, the results will tell if saan talaga yung maximum deflection. So, balik tayo sa MathCAD. Now, I will first assume na, for a while lang. Hindi ko siya pwede. Ah, dapat naka-image pala. For a while. So now, I will first assume na the maximum deflection is nasa AB. Now again, to obtain the location of the maximum deflection, we have to set the slope to 0. Kasi kung saan 0 yung slope, dyan magmamax yung moment. I mean, not moment, but deflection pala. So kukunin ko yung equations that only define segment AB, which are the following. Ito, within AB yan, saka yung uniform load ko, which is 10x cubed divided by 2 multiplied by 3. Ah, ito pala, for deflection. Now, exclude ko muna lahat, yung lahat ng loads from B up to the last point. So, ito lang muna. So, let's go back sa deflection equation. Ito. I will just copy this. Now, machi-check mo naman kasi from 0 to 3 lang yung limits. So, lahat ng merong 3 dyan and then lahat ng merong minus greater than 3, wag mo nang isali. Then, don't forget plus C1 multiplied by X. Yan. Now, set ko to 0. Then, I will solve the value of X. By the way, clear muna natin. Clear X. Yan. So, medyo marami yung roots. Kasi meron kasing X to the 4th. So, gagawin ko, I will just assume all values is greater than 0. Yan, so merong dalawang roots na lang. Press lang natin yung equals. Yan, so we have two roots. Ito, imposible yan. Diba? But the real number, I mean not real number, the realistic root is 11.779. Now, 11.779 does not occur between 0 to 3. So, ibig sabihin pala, the location of the maximum deflection cannot occur when within segment AB. Yan. Kasi this is not within the limit. Now, if I will assume na from 3 to 5 siya, then I have to include all of the equation na. Yan. So, copy ko to. Yan. And then, I can just include this. Yan. Kasi x minus 5, 5 minus 5, magiging 0 lang. So, equals 0. So, solve x. Yan. So, meron tayong ilang roots? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Medyo marami. But ito, this is unrealistic kasi it's greater than, it's not within the limit. Itong 8 din. Not within the limit. And then ito naman, yung dalawa are imaginary numbers. Ito. So yung 5 lang yung realistic. Let's try to check daw sa app natin. The maximum deflection occurs dito. Wait lang, 2.6 dapat yung sagot. So 2.6 is within dito pala. 2.6 is within AB. Na bakit kanina? Bakit wala siya? Wait lang, baka hindi capable yung MathCAD. 33 over 6, tama. Then plus C1X must be equal. Ay, sorry. Sorry. Yung naset natin to 0 is the deflection equation. Ay, ay, ay. Itong slope dapat. Ito lang. So, ito pala dapat yung i-copy ko. Plus C1. Sorry, na-overlook ko. Yan, ito yung equation talaga natin. So, remove ko na lang to kasi alam naman natin. Yan, sa calculator na lang natin isosolve. So, sana yan. Ito pala. Yan. So, 33x squared divided by 2 minus 10x cubed divided by 6, then plus C1. Yung C1 natin was again negative 14783 divided by 180. Yan. So set to 0, shift solve, our guess value must be a realistic value. So between 0 to 3, we have, let's say, 2. So solve for x, 2. Yan, ito pala. The location of the maximum deflection is 2.59771.33.23. So screenshot ko na lang. Dito kasi sa MathCAD, iba kasi. Medyo iba yung nasa solution. Mas maganda sa calculator talaga. So ito yung location ng sana yan? Ito. Ito yung location ng maximum deflection midway between AC. Yan. Now if you will try to check kung na, if the maximum deflection occurs ba sa BC, it will not provide a realistic value. Kasi realistic na kasi to, so for the other side, hindi na yan siya. Now, this is realistic kasi 2.5977 is within 0 to 3. Yan. So, gagawin natin, let's go back sa deflection equation, and then since nasa BC lang tayo, ito lang yung ika-copy natin. Kasi 2.5977 is lesser than 3 saka 5. So, magiging negative na yung nasa loob. So, hindi na yan kasali. Therefore, the maximum deflection is this one. And then, don't forget C1 multiplied by X. Kasi always kasali yan. Kasi X, walang naka-minus. So, yan. Then, clear natin yung X. And then, X must be this value. So, 2.5977133323. So, press equals. Ito pala yung maximum deflection natin. Minus 135.905. So, copy ko na lang. Ito. Ito yung maximum deflection midway between A and C. 135.905. So, deflection max A to C. We have minus 135.905, then KN M cubed divided by EI. Then since negative, the deflection pala is downward. So pag i-check natin yan siya, dito, we have this value. So minus 135.905, which is the same. Yan. So, tama na yung maximum deflection natin. Now, if the question talaga is maximum deflection, ito yung pipiliin natin. Kasi yung deflection at the free end is only 90.483, but mas malaki yung deflection dito sa in between sa simple supports. So, ito na yan. Now, mas madali talaga yung assignments nyo or plates pag meron kayong MathCAD. So, I encourage everyone na mag-download nito. Since meron din naman, this is kasabay din naman sa NumSol or Numerical Solutions. So, ito na lang muna ngayon. Salamat sa pagkikinig. At least, natapos natin lahat. Number 10.